Hey, welcome back to another Luthier's Tips and Tricks video. This one deals with designing the perfect control cavity for your project guitar. We're going to start by making a master template of your layout, complete with the component locations. And then with that master template, we're going to make a template so you can route your cover, your cover access route, and the cavity itself. These are four older videos that I did that I just combined them all together, spliced them up, and I'm going to make one video out of it. So if anybody's looking, they can try my method for making the control cavity for their project guitar. So that being said, why don't I shut up and let's get to it. Welcome back. So this time we are going to design a control cavity. If we have time to make both templates plus a template for the cover, and by both templates I mean the template for the cavity and the template for the route where the cover sits down inside. Take it on the bench, show you what I got so far. I agonize over where controls should be every time I change them on a different style guitar. So I've been agonizing on this for about a week. And this is pretty much what I've come up with. So let's take you down and show you where we are. All right. So I made this little drawing here. The one problem I had with this layout is the thigh cut in here. It's not going to allow me to use separate volumes for each pickup. So we're going to do one volume and one tone. And if you flip this over, you can see got this cut right in here, which is right here. So this is going to sit back like this. It's a little wider this way than I would normally like it. I don't like huge control cavity covers, but you know, it is what it is. So it's going like this. So that is basically how everything's going to sit. So there's enough room in there to solder everything up. Unfortunately, there's not enough room there for three knobs and three pots. So we're just going to go one volume, one tone. Yeah, that's it. So now we have to make three templates. One to route out inside here, right? And then one to route here for the cover to sit down in, and then one for the cover. So the first one I'm going to make is probably the cover. This is very roughly cut out with scissors, so I'm going to take a little extra time, make sure all these lines are straight. So anyway, I'm going to get started with the templates for the routing. All right, so I'll start with the template for the cover. Got my polycarbonate. Luckily, got a nice section here, so if I cut this out right, I won't have too much sanding to do, because I'm going to definitely do doing a lot of it on the belt sander. So let's
rough outline and, you know, pretty much where the screws are going to be laid out and where the holes are going to be drilled for the components. So now let's shape up the outside and see what we come up with. So now I'm going to use a wood block with sandpaper on it and get all the inconsistencies off of that that arc there. I'll be back when I'm done, because watching people sand is freaking boring. Okay, so as I've said in the past, I believe it was in the pick card making video, when sanding your templates, make sure everything is as perfect as you can get it. Excuse me. Because every inconsistency in your template will be transferred to your work. And this template right here is going to make the template for the cover and the template for the recess for the cover. So, granted, if it has a bump or a lump in it, it'll transfer both to the route and to the cover. So, seemingly, the cover should fit perfect anyway. But you don't want that. You want it done right. So get it as perfect as you can. Get all the little humps out. Make sure all your corners are round. Make sure that your corners aren't too tight. Because if they are, the bearing of your router won't be able to go into the corner and out. So, run your finger along any sections that have an arc to them, and you can feel the inconsistencies and go back and take care of them. Especially if you can see them, and I can definitely see them. Make sure all your straight sections are straight. See how nice and straight that is? That one's slightly rounded. I'm going to take care of that. So I went out and got some MDF, and now we're ready to start making these templates. So, let's not wait. Let's get to it. All right, so there's our template for our cavity cover. I've got to remember to flood the outer edge with super glue. We'll save that for later. And let's do... the router template for the recess for the cover. Cover recess template all sanded up. Let's take you down here and show you how the two fit together.
All right. So we took care of this on the spindle sander and worked with it with hand sanding and not too bad. So now we know that the cover is going to fit inside the route for it correctly.
Nice. Okay, so let's take it over to drill press and we'll hog it out with the Forstner bits, and then I'll take it over to the spindle sander. We'll sand this whole thing out again, and then I'll be back. Okay, there it is. Kind of funky looking, but that's all the open area in the cavity. You can put these two together, and this is pretty much a mock-up of what your cavity is going to look like. And we'll pretend this is the cover. Not bad. So that's it. So to recap, drew it out on paper. Made a master template. Used that template to make this template. This is the cover template. Used this template to make this template. And then used this template to draw the outline, and then just sort of freehanded the on the inside. This one doesn't need to be precise, doesn't need to be pretty. It's just a hole and it's covered up. So, and it's time to route out the control cavities. To start with, taking my original template, and I've got marked out where the three components are going. Tone control, toggle switch, volume control. And drilled a hole all the way through. I'm going to put it on the back of the guitar. And ran a drill down through it just to make a mark where I want them to be. Now I'm going to take this over to the drill press and blow a hole all the way through, so you'll be able to see the holes through the front. So let's do that. Okay, so got the component locations drilled through. Now I'm going to apply the template and hog out the majority of the cavity with the Forstner bits, and we'll be back to route. Mm-hmm. All right, so we got that routed out. There it is. Looks good. Getting ready to route the channel for the cover cavity. And as you see, it's going to route way too deep. So what I'm going to do is put another layer of MDF on there and make a thicker template. This will allow you to lift it up more. So let's do it. Dries to rot out the hole in the middle. All right, so there she is, all glued up. While we were away, I took the liberty of routing out the cavity. Now I'm going to, I also countersunk the pots a little bit so they would sit further in, especially the toggle switch. That's not designed to be in such thick wood. So we are in the front. So now let's route the cover. I got some 3-ply pickguard material mounted to my cover template. Let's go do it. Cover fits nice, just loose enough that I don't think we'll have a problem with the finish. And it's proud maybe 4 to 6 thousandths. So I think it should be right once we get some finish on it. If not, I'll worry about sanding down the back of it later. Cool. Now, let's poke a hole through the side of this thing for the barrel jack. Anyway, see you in the next video. Guys, behave yourself. Peace. Four or five older videos that I did, and I just figured that it'd be good to splice these all up together and get everything in one video for anybody who's looking for a good way to make a cavity cover.